In this video, we're going to explore the quotient rule a little bit more. We're going to make sure we don't confuse it with just reducing a fraction. So when you see numbers, you're going to reduce those as you would a fraction. And when you see exponent expressions, then you can apply the quotient rule if you have like bases. So go ahead and look at that first expression, negative 14 over negative 2, and think about how you would reduce that fraction. If you divide by negative 2, you'll get a 7 in the numerator and a 1 in the denominator. So the new expression would be 7y to the 6th power over y squared. And then you can subtract our exponents. 6 is the greater exponent, so I'm going to start my subtraction in the numerator. 6 minus 2 equals 4. And I'm going to mark off the exponent that I subtracted in the denominator so that I don't use it anymore. I'm going to use a placeholder of 1 down there. And I'm going to write 7y to the 4th in the numerator and my placeholder 1 in the denominator. And the reason I did that was just to keep it straight where I'm supposed to put everything. Now I can eliminate the denominator and my final expression is 7y to the 4th power. Now you can do this in steps like I just showed you, or you can do it all at once. In the next expression, if you focus on the fraction part first and divide by 2, you'll have a negative 2 in the numerator and a 1 in the denominator, and you have reduced the fraction. Then we're going to look at pairs of exponents that we could subtract. On the x's, your 3 is positive and in the numerator, so we're going to start subtracting those exponents in the numerator, and the x will have a 3 minus negative 4, or 3 plus 4 on it, which would be a 7. So I'm going to make sure I keep that in the numerator. The y's, since 4 is the greater exponent on the y's, I'm going to start that subtraction in the denominator. 4 minus 2 is 2, so I will make sure I put my y squared in the denominator. So this is me putting all of my work here, and it's showing a negative 2 and an x to the 7th now in the numerator, and the y squared in the denominator with all the subtraction and all the canceling done. And that's my final expression. Let's look at a few more. In these expressions, I'm going to be able to use the product rule in addition to the quotient rule. For example, in the first expression, x to the negative 7 times x to the negative 4, I can add those exponents. Negative 7 plus negative 4 equals negative 11. So I will write the new expression as x to the negative 11 over x to the negative 8. And then I will subtract exponents. And I'd really like to subtract a negative 11 in the denominator, so that's what I'm going to do. Negative 8 minus negative 11 is the same as negative 8 plus 11, which is 3. I will have eliminated my x to the negative 11 in the numerator, so I'm going to put a placeholder of 1 up there. And I'm going to write the new expression, 1 over x to the 3rd power. In the second expression, below, on the bottom of the screen, first I'm going to take a look at the numbers that I have in the problem and reduce those numbers. So with 32 and 18, I can divide by 2, and that will leave me a 16 and a 9. And then I also have another 9 in the problem, so I can actually divide the 9s out, cancel the 9s out, and that would leave me with just 1s in those positions. So my new expression after reducing will be 16 x to the 8th power, x to the negative 4th power over y, x to the 6th power. Then I'm going to add my exponents in my numerator. So 8 plus negative 4 is positive 4, and that will give me 16 x to the 4th in the numerator and y, x to the 6th in the denominator. Now I can subtract exponents, and I'm going to begin subtracting in the denominator this time. 6 minus 4 is equal to 2. I will have eliminated my x to the 4th in the numerator, and I have a 16 up there, so I don't need another placeholder. And my final answer will be 16 over y x squared. I'm going to give you 4 more examples that you can practice with, and you can pause the video and practice the skills, and then come back and check your answers. And here are the answers for you. The first expression reduces to 5y. the second expression, 1 over x to the 22nd power. The third expression is 8 over yx to the 12th. And the fourth expression is negative 6x to the 4th over y to the 3rd. You can take a look at all of the work involved, and good luck as you practice these skills.